Leaving the glacier, we head back towards Otley. We are going back a different way to see some ancient stone alignments and also to avoid the deep river crossing. The track back is extremely rocky, worse than the way in, and Bob gets stuck on a rock, looking at the map when he should have been driving.
Pinch in action.
He brought it all this way.
I said, why did he go that way and not this way?
Pete quickly winches him off, but unknown at the time, a hairline crack in the front dip will leave the vehicle stranded in the coming weeks. For most of the trip, the big Ford has excelled. But here on the tight, rocky trails and nursing a cracked fuel tank, Pete is anxious and would have preferred to go out the way we came in. I find these ancient sites fascinating, and we camp the night while the rest go on to the river, hoping to catch some fish.
GPS is 249. At southeast, about 138 degrees.
Often these alignments relate to the sun rising at a point on the hill at some certain time of the year. In this way, the people, or priests, who were usually in charge, knew exactly what day it was. Throughout the Altai Mountains, we have been in a national park and expected a lot of vegetation, even some wildlife. But everywhere, domestic animals were grazing. And I thought the whole region was overgrazed and facing long-term environmental problems. The only ungrazed areas were on small islands or inaccessible mountains. Anxious that I might still have to drive across the big river, I was relieved when the bridge came into view, no matter what condition it was in. Our Mongolian visa expires in a few days and we race back to the border and to meet up with the rest of the group. Bob hits a big hole and his rear shocker is torn out. He's not impressed, as they were new at the start of the trip. He thinks they were the wrong ones for the Land Rover. He's carrying the old ones and we all help change it. The wind cuts down the valley and is bitterly cold, and the repairs went very slowly.
Won't fit?
We all camped just short of the border, and there we meet up with some Landrovers from Poland. They were very experienced travellers, and it was interesting to see how they fitted out their vehicles. Like this net on the bonnet for drying clothes, and also for walking on the bonnet. And this loop in the roof rack is a step to climb up. And this checker plate on the lower panels. And these side lights on the roof rack. In the afternoon, they left to line up at the border, anxious to be the first to cross. 7:30 the next morning, we headed for the border, unaware it would be 34 hours till we cleared Russian customs.